So in this Python certification series, we'll understand how to install Python on your machine. I will also teach you to set up your Jupyter Notebook environment for performing demos and hands-on in our course. So the very first thing that we'll be doing is installing Python on our system. So I have already installed Python in my system. For those of you who don't have it, you can download it and get it installed from its official website, www.python.org/download. So let me just show you how easy is it to install Python on your system. Let me open my default browser and I'll write here www.python.org/download. So as you can see here, we have a download option of download Python 3.7.1. If you want a different version, for Windows, Linux, or Mac, you can just click over to these links. For example, if I am a Windows user and I want a different version of it, then let's see. I click the link and you can download different versions of Python from here. So the first two options that we got up here is latest Python 3 release, Python 3.7.1, and latest Python 2 release, Python 2.7.15. Now these are the two popular versions of Python. Now which version should you download? Well, I have installed Python 3 in my machine. In the past, there was a bit of debate in the coding community about which Python version was the best one to learn, Python 2 or Python 3, specifically Python 2.7 or Python 3.5 or 3.7. Alright, let me just tell you, Python 2 has been the most popular version for a decade and a half and is still in demand at certain companies. However, more companies are moving from Python 2 to Python 3. For example, in 2017, Instagram migrated the majority of their Python codebase from Python 2.7 to Python 3. As with each newer version of Python, it is getting a faster runtime. On the other hand, nobody is currently working on to make Python 2.7 work faster. Also, the community support for Python 3 is more better. So for someone who wants to learn Python programming for beginner, I'd suggest that you should avoid spending time on a version that is becoming obsolete. Well, let's download Python 3 for Windows. So let's directly jump up to our first window and click on download Python 3.7.1. Download it. So yeah, it's downloaded. Just click over the .exe file and follow the installation step and it will get installed. Click it. Click on the install now version. Select the drive where you want to install it and click on the next and it will be installed on your machine. Alright, so let's click on the install now option. Yes. And the setup will install Python on my system. Well, if you are starting Python, you'll find that you'll have various options where you can write down your codes and get it executed. By default, we use the Python CLI. You can use any text editor like Notepad or Notepad++. Or you can even use any Python IDE like Anaconda, which has Jupyter Notebook and Spider pre-installed in it. Python is majorly based on indentation. So these IDEs will help you a lot while coding and debugging your program. So by then my setup was successful. Let's close it. For this tutorial, I'll be using Jupyter Notebook, which is a web-based application that will allow me to write my Python codes on it. It's ready to use and it gives me an interactive data science environment. Alright, if you're installing Jupyter Notebook and Python, I would strongly recommend you to use the Anaconda distribution, which already includes the Python, the Jupyter Notebook, and other commonly used packages for starting with Python. Alright, so for downloading it, let's visit the website www.anaconda.com/download. Let's open our default browser, www.anaconda.com/downloads. So as you can see, we have a download option up here. Just click over it and your installation will start. Open the downloaded file and follow this series of steps and install Anaconda on your machine. Alright? So for me, I have already installed Anaconda on my system. So let me just go over there and open it. Anaconda Navigator. This might take some time to start. So this is how the Anaconda Navigator looks like after the installation. From here, I'll select my Jupyter Notebook and hit the launch button. My Jupyter Notebook will open in my default browser. So here's my Jupyter Notebook. It opened on the local host with port number 8889. So this is how the Jupyter Notebook will look like. So from here, go on to the new, select Python 3 from the notebook. And this will redirect you to the Python notebook page where you can write all the different sorts of Python codes on it, ranging from a beginner level to an advanced one. Now that we have set up our environment for coding, let me just give you a glimpse of how easy is Python. You want to perform addition? It's as simple as 1 plus 2 equals 3. That's it. All you need to do is 1 plus 2 and hit enter. You'll get the output. So this was all for this session. In our next session, we'll be learning about various Python variables and tokens. Thank you.